Hi, and welcome back to my new video about what is measure in the context of the Safe for DevOps Health Radar. Please note that everything that I'm going to say and everything that I'm going to show you is under the license of Scaled Agile. Please also note that the Scaled Agile framework is a framework. Use it as a toolbox. Take out of this toolbox what fits your needs and what solves your problems. This video is part of a series of videos where I am going through the Safe for DevOps Health Radar, which you can see here. And when you want to know more about the Safe for DevOps Health Radar, you can watch my video up here. The Safe for DevOps Health Radar starts with the customer or with the business. They have bright ideas. We take these bright ideas and put them into epics, and we identify in these epics the real hypothesis behind this epic. With this epic hypothesis statement, we are going into collaborate and research. There we are going to identify the real market need or the real customer need. After that, we are going to architect. We are going to architect the minimal amount of architecture which is needed to prove the hypothesis of the epic. Then we are going into synthesize. There we are going to break down the epic into features and put these features on a backlog where we can prioritize them, where we can build up a roadmap, and also where we can elaborate on our vision. With these features, we are going into develop. There we are going to break down the features into user stories and start developing these user stories. Then we are committing our source code into the version control, and we are building our deployable artifact. This deployable artifact is then tested end to end and then put onto the staging environment for final verification. Then we are deploying this new functionality into production with the feature toggle off. Then we verify with a subset of the tests if everything is okay in production. And we continuously monitor our production system if everything works as expected. If anything happens in production, we get alerted, and as one team, we are going to respond to these issues. When the business says now is the right time to release the new functionality to the users, we are going to switch on the feature toggle. With the switched on feature toggle, we now are going to stabilize our production environment, are going to check if everything works according to the SLAs. And with that, we are going into measure. Let's see what we are doing there. Now, in the measure step, everything from the Safe for DevOps Health Radar comes together, because now we are starting to collect qualitative but also quantitative information about an epic or a feature in production. Because we want to identify the business value behind the epics and the features, and also prove the hypothesis of these epics and of these features, so that we are able to make informed strategic decisions. For example, by stopping some epics, or also stopping some features, or by saying, okay, this hypothesis is true, we are going to invest more in this feature or more in this epic. Perhaps you remember back in the hypothesis step, we talked already about epics. You can watch my video up here about the whole hypothesis step. An epic is a significant initiative, and behind such an epic, there is always a hypothesis. And we need to identify the hypothesis behind this epic. And we use for that the epic hypothesis statement, which you can see up here. Just as a recap, in the hypothesis step, which you can rewatch in this video up here, we are going with the EPIC in the so-called lean startup cycle, which you can see here. As said, behind an EPIC, there is always a hypothesis. And with the lean startup cycle, we are trying to identify the minimal viable product which we can build to prove if the hypothesis is true or false. And this is done with the leading indicators, because with the leading indicators, we can identify if we are building the right thing. And to identify this, we use the application telemetry, which we have built into our solution. Of course, we now need to correlate the business results and the telemetry so that we can identify if the hypothesis is true or false. And please be aware of the vanity metrics. Vanity metrics can, for example, be the number of downloads. Perhaps this is not the right metric or the right leading indicator to measure in your case. But also, vanity metrics can depend on the context in which you are. Of course, we are not only going to measure the hypothesis of our EPICs, but we are also going to measure the benefit hypothesis of our feature or of the enabler features. We talked already about features in the video about Synthesize, which you can see up here. In the Synthesize step, we are going to take the EPIC and we are going to break down the EPIC into features or enabler features. A feature has a title, it has a set of acceptance criteria, and it has also important non-functional requirements. But the most important thing about the feature is the benefit hypothesis. And this benefit hypothesis is exactly what we are going to measure in the measure step. So the output of the measure step is that we have qualitative and quantitative feedback about our EPICs and features. For features, we want to identify if they fulfill the benefit hypothesis which was stated in the feature. For an EPIC, we of course want to validate if the hypothesis is true or false. And of course, we also want to identify if we are able to deliver the business value. Here we have the periodic table of DevOps tools, which you can see here. And the tools which we can use for the measure steps are the AIOps and analytics tools, which you can see there in orange. I brought you three examples of such tools. First, there is Matomo, which you can use when you are in an on-premise environment. And there is Google Analytics, which you can see here, which you can use when you are in the cloud. And the third one is Dynatrace, which you can see down here. The Safe for DevOps Health Radar is an assessment. You can download the assessment over this link down here. It is an Excel file. Measurement involves collecting factual information about the value of a deployed feature and evaluating it against the original hypothesis statement. Rate your team's ability to collect objective information about the actual value realized by deployed features so that it can inform strategic financial decisions. You are sit when we don't deliver or measure the value of features. You are crawl when we've defined what value is but don't know how to measure it. You are walk when we capture qualitative feedback from the business about the value of features. And we are a run when we capture qualitative and quantitative feedback from the business and our monitoring systems about the value of our features. And we are a fly when we aggregate the qualitative and quantitative feedback to objectively validate the original hypothesis and inform, pivot, or persevere decisions. In the measure step, everything from the SAFe for DevOps Health Radar comes together. Here we are going to collect quantitative and qualitative information about our epics and features in production. With this information, we are able to identify if the hypothesis or the benefit hypothesis of epics and features are true. And this enables us to make informed decisions whether we are going to invest more into our features and epics or less, or even stop some epics and features. And with that, we are at the end of this video. Please leave me a thumbs up if you liked this video, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel, because the next video will be Learn.